In this session, I'm going to talk about fixed assets in Business Central. I'm going to go to Finance, Fixed Assets. Here you could add as many assets as you want. Not only could you add assets, but you could record acquisition values and run depreciation. So let's go into New. Just hit Enter or Tab, and it's going to give you an number based on your setup in the number series. This can be alphanumeric, as you see, FA00014. This could be set up to any numeric value you want it to be, or alphanumeric. Simply go right into the description and describe the asset. And let's just say it is a company car. And what type of class does it belong to? The class and subclass are not mandatory fields, but they are certainly nice to have. It gives you the ability to filter on reports and or depreciation based on a class or subclass or even location. So if we look at the class, these are just examples. You could create as many and different classes that suit your needs. So we'll say in this case, it's a tangible asset. What's my subclass? My subclass, again, is just an example you could set to your needs. And we're going to say vehicle. And what location does it belong to? So if you have multiple locations across the board, whether it's a street address or a building, whatever the case may be, you're going to decide where you want to put that. So let's just say, oh, it's in warehouse one. You could track the serial number of the asset if it has one. You could, if a employee is responsible for it, maybe if it's a car, they're always driving, or a truck, they're always driving it. You could put that employee number. If it's a laptop, a computer, you could put that employee that you handed it over to, and so forth. Again, these are for filtering capabilities, so that way you could see and view and reports who owns it, what class is it, what subclass is it, and so forth. Okay. You have blocked and inactive. You could set these up and, you know, by turning them on or off if you don't want anybody to use that asset. Sometimes what you may want to do is create the asset ahead of time and then inactivate it or block it until you actually get the acquisition for it. Down here in the depreciation book, you're going to decide what type of depreciation book you're going to use. What's the posting group, which typically defaults in based on the subclass, based on how you set this up. So because it's a subclass of vehicle, it's actually linked to default classes and subclasses and FA posting groups based on the subclass. Depreciation method, you'll see there's straight line, double declining, double decline two, and so forth. There's a lot of different methods, and we won't get into all the different methods and calculations. In most cases, it's always straight line, and we could talk about further methods down the road. We'll stick with straight line. When's the depreciation start date? The system will actually, I'll just choose, let's say, the 15th of the month, since it's October right now, and I'll just be hit it in the middle, right? Just go right down the middle and say, oh, it's going to start on the 15th. How many years does it depreciate? Let's just say it's 6 years. And you'll see that the system automatically calculated the end of depreciation date based on the start date and the number of years. Okay. You can track the maintenance information for this, whether it's a company car, piece of equipment. You could choose which vendor you purchased it from, which vendor you're maintaining it from. Is it under maintenance, yes or no? When's the next service date? When's the warranty date? And so forth. So this is just information you could track on the individual asset. That way you could run a report if you'd like to. If you have a lot of assets, whether it's within your you have a fleet of cars or you have a large warehouse of different vehicles and you do service on them, you could run a report based on when's the next service date for this month or next month so you can prepare for service on those vehicles or pieces of equipment. So as far as entering the asset, that's all there is to it. So let's add a value to this. And adding the value, there's two methods of doing it. One is through the GL journal. So if I do fixed asset, GL journal. Here is basically like a journal entry, if you will. Expand this out and let's choose 1015 again. What am I doing? My type is going to be fixed asset. Which fixed asset am I acquiring? I'm going to do my company car. FA type, I'm doing acquisition. And how much is it for? And I'm just going to say this was for $45,000. And then, of course, my balance account, which is going to be my asset account. And I'll just put it in as equipment for now. And I'm just going to go and post it. Successful. Now, if I go back into my asset, you will see my book value now is $45,000. I could actually drill down into it and get the actual ledger entries. The other method can be through payables. So through the purchase invoicing, if I create a new purchase invoice, and I'm going to choose a vendor, down in my type, I could just simply change this as fixed asset. Which fixed asset? I'm acquiring it. 21 and 45,000. I will not post it, although I could post this and it'll add 45,000 to the asset. So you could acquire it more than one time, if you will. So it just basically increases the value of that asset. But I won't do that. I just want to show you through the AP process, you could actually acquire fixed assets as well. Just a note too, you'd have to create the fixed asset record for it to go onto the invoice. Escape out. What you can also do within the fixed assets is run depreciation. So now that I'm on the fixed asset list, I'm going to go to process, calculate depreciation. And in here, you're going to say, to what's the end date do I want to run depreciation through? So I'm in October, so I'm going to choose the 30th of October. And I'm going to post it as of the 30th of October. And then you can put it, use a document number and posting description and just click OK. Said depreciation has been calculated. Two journals were created. Do you want to open it? Yes, I do, because it opens up the journal. And lo and behold, I have my company car asset of 40. And then, of course, I had another one prior to that for 130. And you'll see my calculations down here, it actually is going to put a credit to my actual asset record itself, right? And then the debit amount to my accumulated depreciation. Now, if I go and actually post this, successful. Now, if I go into my asset again, you'll see my book value has gone down from 45,000 to 44,667. I'm going to drill into the details and you'll see my first line on the 15th was $45,000. And as of 15 days later, the end of the month of the 30th of October, it took away $333, netting my true book value of 44,667. So the system really keeps track of tight calculated depreciation because they actually depreciates on a daily basis. So if there's 28 days, it's going to take 28 days. If it's 31 days, it's going to take 31 days, and et cetera. So that's a high-level overview of what you can expect with fixed assets. Thanks for watching. If we can further assist you, please reach out to us here at the EPCgroup.net.